Maybe on a camel, or if you were on a donkey, this donkey, because of the pressure, or this camel, because of the pressure and the weight, even this one, it would sit down. Zaid ibn Thabit radiallahu ta'ala, subhanAllah, he says that one day I was sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his knee was sort of touching my knee. He says that all of a sudden, revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala began descending. And he said it had so much weight and so much power that I felt that my own knee was going to smash. Just imagine how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would have felt. This is just the knee of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam touching Zaid ibn Thabit's knee. He's saying that I felt as if my knee was going to smash. This is how much pressure it had. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he refers to this wahi, the weight of this wahi in the Quran. Allah says, "Inna sanulqi alayka qawlan saqila," that very soon we are going to descend you a very weighty discourse. This weighty discourse, what is it talking about? It's talking about the wahi that descends from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, if you look, you know, when something unusual happens to us, we all of a sudden we become uneasy. We become uneasy and we will get frightened. Now this is a huge angel in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you can just imagine the weight that must have been coming and being pressured upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, if you have this experience, it was out of human nature that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he got scared. Allah subhanahu wa taala, to every single Nabi he has given miracles, and Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, one of Musa alayhi salam's miracles, they were the Allah subhanahu, he would have a stick, a big staff, and this staff, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he would use it to herd his sheep, and he would use it to knock down leaves of the tree for his goats. Now when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he granted Musa alayhi salatu wasalam a miracle, one of the miracles was that this staff, when Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he would throw it down, all of a sudden this staff, it would change into a huge serpent. Now initially when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he granted Musa alayhi salatu wasalam this miracle, Allah told him to throw the staff down. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he threw the staff down, and the staff, it changed into a huge serpent, and the serpent, it began moving. When Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he seen this, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he turned around and he ran. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? أَقْبِلْ وَلَا تَخَفْ إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْآمِنِينَ. Now turn around and don't be scared. It was purely out of human nature that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he got scared. Halanke, if we look, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he was amongst the, well, all the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, they were brave. But Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he was known for his strength and known for his bravery. Once Musa alayhi salatu, the angel of death, it came to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. So what does Musa alayhi salam do? Musa alayhi salam turns around and he gives it a slap. He gives it a slap, it goes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he tells Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Musa alayhi salam attacked me. This was, you know, this was the bravery of Musa alayhi salam. Once Musa alayhi salam, he was bathing, what would happen in, at the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, this is the hadith of Bukhari. It says in the hadith that the nation of Musa alayhi salatu, the people of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, what they would do is when they would have a bath, they would all have a bath together. In the same river, they would all take their clothes off, the men, women, everybody mix, and they would go and they would have a bath. Now Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, due to modesty and due to haya, he would go and he would have a shower or a bath somewhere else in a different stream. So because of this, they began accusing Musa alayhi salatu wasalam of having a disease which was related to the private parts. So one day when Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he was in, at the river where he was bathing, Allah, and he took his clothes off and he put them on a rock. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he ordered this rock to move and run. So this rock with the clothes of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, it began running. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he instructed the rock to go to the place where all these people were bathing. When Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he seen this, he didn't have no choice. He has to run behind the rock to get his clothes. Allahu Akbar, this rock, it comes and it stands in front of these people where these people are bathing. And all these people, they see this rock coming towards them, and then they see Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, and his satr is uncovered, and they see that his private parts, they are totally pure and they are perfect from any sort of disease. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sort of cleared Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, and he cleared him from the rumors. Now it says in the hadith that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he had got his clothes, he beat the rock up so bad, it was so bad that there were marks left on the rock. This was the bravery of Musa alayhi salam. But after seeing this stuff all of a sudden change into a moving serpent, even somebody like Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, purely because of human nature. Even Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he got scared. So Allah had to say to him, "Aqbil wa la takhaf innaka min al-amineen." Turn around and don't be scared, oh Musa. Innaka min al-amineen, you are amongst those who are in peace. So Allah has to even tell Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, so anyway, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he comes and he tells Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. Hazrat Khadija, what does she begin with? She begins consoling and comforting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And she begins telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, so mentioning some of the good attributes that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam had. And she said that wallahi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will never ever let you down. Why? You are amongst those people who reconciliate between people. You go and you do sila rahmi between people. When two people are in an argument, you go and you cause peace between these people. You reconciliate between these people. Then she says that you are the most truthful. You always speak the truth. You go visit the poor and you visit the sick. You in one narration it says that you have never approached a sin. You have never gone close to the sin of fornication. And in one riwayat, it's been mentioned by Ibn Ishaq in Sirat Ibn Hisham, it says that Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala, one of the things that she had said was, she said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that I swear by the one in whose hands Khadija's life is in, that I have a strong hope that you are the Prophet of this ummah. This shows that this is why Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, she wasn't taken back. She wasn't shocked that all this had happened. Hazrat Khadija, rather, she was expecting this to happen. Because I've mentioned before that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he returned on the journey, from the journey, when he went to Syria for Hazrat Khadija on the business trip. When he came back, Hazrat Khadija, when she opened her window, she seen that there were angels and they were giving shade to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when she had gone and mentioned this, her cousin brother Waraka ibn Nawfal, he said that if this is true, then this person, he will become a Nabi of this ummah. So Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala, she did have no doubt at all. She was expecting something like this to happen. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came and he told her, then it wasn't no shock, it wasn't no surprise. She had just comforted him, she was consoling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After this had happened, after he explained everything and she had comforted him, just for more comfort and just to console him even more, Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, she went to her cousin brother Waraka ibn Nawfal and she explained the whole situation to Waraka that what happened. So Waraka, now Hazrat Khadija, you have to remember that she had gone on her own the first time. So when she went and she told Waraka, Waraka, he said to her that if what you are speaking is true, then this is the angel that descended to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. This is the first time she goes. Waraka ibn Nawfal, he mentions the name of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Then the same day, or probably the next day, Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, she took the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she went away, she went to Waraka and she said to Waraka that, you know, oh my cousin, listen to the story yourself. And she told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to explain the story. Huzur sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explained the full story to Waraka ibn Nawfal. So Waraka ibn Nawfal, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that this is the angel that descended to Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam. Now in the first time Hazrat Khadija went, it was Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. This time when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he went and he explained everything, it was Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Why? The ulama alayhim ar-rahmah, they go into a lengthy discussion why he said Musa, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, and why he said the second time, why did he say Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. There's a long reason, I don't want to really go into it. Anyway, after this, Waraka ibn Nawfal, he says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I wish that I was strong and I wish that I was young and healthy. That when your people, they force you out, when they exile you, then I can help you in such a situation. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was shocked. Because obviously Makkah was his, you know, it was his home. He loved Makkah. It showed how much the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved Makkah. That when the Waraka, he said this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was extremely shocked. He said that, what, they're gonna force me out of my own home? He said to him that not only you, every Nabi that has ever come, every Nabi that has come and every Nabi that has brought the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their people, they have exiled them, they have forced them out, and not only forced them out, they have become an enemy of that person. Allah Akbar. Now so Waraka ibn Nawfal, he, just before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he leaves, Waraka ibn Nawfal, he kisses the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his forehead. And in one narration, it comes that he said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أبشر فأنا أشهد أنك الذي بشر به ابن مريم. That receive glad tidings, because I testify that you are the one regarding whom Ibn Maryam, the son of Maryam alayhi salatu wa salam, Isa alayhi salam, he gave us glad tidings about. You are that person who Isa alayhi salam told us about that he is going to come and he is going to come as a prophet. وَإِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ مِثْلِنَا مُوسِ مُوسَىٰ. And you are with an angel similar to the one that would come to Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. وَإِنَّكَ نَبِيٌّ مُرْسَلٌ. And you are